Good morning, hi, and welcome back to Kids Church Online with me, Marcus. I hope you guys are doing really well out there, that you've had a good week, and that you've been enjoying this warmer weather that we've been starting to have. Last week, we were looking at how the church got started after the day of Pentecost. This morning, we're going to be finding out about what happened next to them and what it means for us today as Jesus' friends here in 2021. But before we get onto that, let's have a quick look now at what's coming up in the rest of today's session. We've got worship, we've got our Bible story and our teaching time. We've got a memory verse and a creative craft for you guys at home to make together. We've got some videos to watch, some things to find out about, and lots more besides. So what are we waiting for? Let's get ready to worship.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. To show. Such a cool thing to know that he's listening. Help us, Lord, to breathe. In the rain or the sun, we can talk to the one who set the stars in place. When you're not sure what to do, he's the one you can turn to. We need to pray, yeah, yeah, 'cause prayer can move a mountain. Need to pray, yeah, yeah, and give it all to him. We need to pray, yeah, yeah, believing that he's listening. Whoa, oh, 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 he loves it when we pray. Or we're down or just spinning round, help us Lord to pray. When we're happy or sad or frustrated and mad, help us Lord to pray. When just simply believing is hard, 'cause he's feeling a million miles away, help us to be strong, let this always be our song. We need to pray, 'cause prayer can move a mountain. Need to pray, it's not weird or odd. Help us Lord to pray. When you're not sure what to do, he's the one you can turn to.
Our Bible story this morning comes from the book of Acts. It's Acts chapter 5 verses 17 to 42 if you want to read about it later in your Bibles at home. Let's watch this clip now and find out about what happened next to the leaders of the early church.
Stories of the Bible. The Apostles and the High Council. These are the apostles.
Hello.
They followed Jesus during his time on earth.
See ya.
After he went to heaven, Jesus sent the Holy Spirit to be their helper. Then the apostles spread the good news about Jesus everywhere they went. The apostles performed many miracles and healed the sick. They met regularly in the temple in Jerusalem, and many came to believe in Jesus. Huh. All this made the Jewish high priest and his officials very jealous, so they arrested the apostles and put them in jail. But an angel of the Lord came in the night.
Whoa!
And opened the gate of the jail. The angel told them to go to the temple and tell people about Jesus.
Got it.
So at daybreak, the apostles went to the temple and told people about Jesus as the angel told them to. Meanwhile, the high priest and his officials called together a meeting of the high council. They sent the guards to bring the apostles out of jail, but when they went to the jail, they were gone.
Wait, what?
They returned to the council and reported that the men were gone.
Guess what?
Then someone arrived and announced that the men who were in jail were standing in the temple, teaching people.
Go get them!
The captain went with his temple guards and arrested the apostles.
Come on, you.
They brought them before the high council. The high priest said, "We gave you strict orders never again to teach in this man's name."
Yeah, but...
But Peter and the apostle said, "We must obey God rather than any human authority." They told Jesus' story, that he was raised from the dead after they hung him on the cross, and that now he was in heaven. They told them that Jesus did all these things so that people of Israel would turn to God and be forgiven for their sins. This made the high council furious, and they decided to kill the apostles. But one Pharisee named Gamaliel stood up and ordered that the men be sent outside the council for a while. Then he warned his fellow Jewish leaders that killing the apostles might bring more trouble than good. He advised them to leave the apostles alone.
That's a good point.
The other Pharisees saw his point and accepted his advice. They called the apostles in and had them beat up, but they didn't kill them. They ordered them to never speak in the name of Jesus, and then they let them go. The apostles left the high council happy that God thought them worthy to suffer for preaching the name of Jesus. And every day in the temple and from house to house, they continued to teach and preach this message: Jesus is the Messiah.
Well, have any of you guys out there ever been criticized by other people or had them say mean things about you or to you because you chose to do the right thing? Have you ever had to stand up for somebody else who couldn't protect themselves? Well, faithfulness, or sticking with God no matter what, is proof that God is at work in each one of our lives. And faithfulness can be seen in many, many different ways. But most importantly, it means standing up for the things that we say we believe in because it's the right thing to do. Well, the apostles, Jesus' friends and followers, had an unstoppable belief in him that made many people feel upset and angry. It even made others feel jealous, including, as we saw in today's story, the high priest, who gave orders to kill them if they ever again spoke the name of Jesus. But God rescued them and help them to keep telling as many people as they could about his love for them and about the good news of Jesus. And the apostles weren't scared or worried because they knew that they were doing the right thing, what God had asked them to do. As Jesus' friends and followers here in Hildenborough and Tunbridge in 2021, we have chances to do what God asks us every single day. Now, sometimes it can feel like the people around us, our friends who don't know God yet, don't want to hear about Jesus or what he's done for them or how much he loves them. And sometimes it can seem like those same people around us who don't yet know God's love for them want to try and stop us from sharing the good news of Jesus. And at the same time, they have never needed to hear about his love for them more than now. And there are probably people that we know, people like our friends at school, or even people in our own families, who would prefer us to stop talking about Jesus and trying to share God's love with them by what we say and what we do. But the Bible encourages us to never give up and to never stop trying, because it is what God asks his friends, that's me and that's you, to do. And when God asks us to do something, it is always the right thing for us to do. I'd like to throw out a challenge now to you and to me, to everybody who knows that they're God's friend. When we next have the chance to speak up for Jesus and we're tempted to say nothing and not do the right thing, I want us to think about everything that Jesus did to share God's love with other people. Jesus never, ever stopped, even when it meant that people said and did really mean things to him. And Jesus kept on sharing the good news of God's love with people, even when it meant that he knew that he was going to be killed for it. Jesus stood up and spoke out for the people that others didn't think were important or loved by God, and he did that when nobody else would. Well, as God's friends and followers of Jesus, each one of us is called first to obey him and to do what he asks. Not the people around us who have different ideas or don't know him yet. And God promises to always give us the power and the strength to do what he asks, even if it means the people around us don't understand or try to make life difficult for us. Let's hit pause for a second and think about three questions with the people around us that we're watching this session with before we ask God for his help. Question number one, has there been a time recently that you chose not to say anything when you had a chance to share with other people about Jesus and God's love for them? Question number two, why did you choose not to say anything? Question number three, how can you plan to speak up for Jesus the next time that you have a chance? Love to chat to God now for us as we finish our teaching time. And if you would like to join in with this prayer at home, then you can say Amen at the end, which is just another way of saying, I agree with that. May that be real and true in my life too. Dear God, thank you that you ask us to obey you first before anybody else in our lives. And we thank you that you're always with us, no matter what. Help us not to worry about what other people might say or think when we speak up for you. And make us strong and brave through the power of your Holy Spirit who lives inside each one of us. I ask these things in the incredible name of Jesus. Amen.
Hey, and welcome to our craft instructional video. Our craft for today is a tiny shadow box of Peter escaping from prison. We will be using these cute fuzzy wires as bendable prison bars. To make this craft, we will need a single hole puncher, some fuzzy wire, the coloring page template, a hole marker template for the holes later on, a pen, a pastry box 5 by 3.5 inches, double-sided tape, some scissors. Let's begin. Take the pastry box and stick the coloring page to the base of the box. Let's use the white side of the box. We won't be assembling the box just yet. The kids will do that inside the classroom. But we will need to put holes on the top and bottom flaps of the box. This is where the fuzzy wire prison bars are going to go through. We need 7 holes for 7 bars. You may use the provided template to mark the top and the bottom of the box. Mark at the edgemost portion of the top and bottom flap. And make sure to use the biggest hole puncher for this so the kids don't have a hard time inserting the fuzzy wires. It should look something like this. Next, take the fuzzy wires and cut them in half. We need 7 pieces per craft kit. To protect the kids from being scratched or poked by the wires, cover the ends with masking tape. I know this is an extra step for all of us, but I'm sure the parents of the little ones will appreciate the effort to keep their kids safe. The complete craft kit must contain the pastry box with the coloring page attached to it, fuzzy wires, and crayons. Color and design the coloring page, then assemble your pastry box as such. Insert the fuzzy wires through the holes in your box. Teachers, you may help the kids fold the wires over to secure them better. And that's it! You're now done with your craft. You can now pretend to break Peter free from the prison by bending the fuzzy wires. Thanks for watching!
Our memory verse this morning is Acts 5, verse 29. Peter and the other apostles replied, "We must obey God rather than human beings." Things to know before you go. A reminder that all things being well, with restrictions being lifted, we will be looking to start Kids Church in person at St John's on Sunday, June the 27th. So if you haven't already got that date in your diary, in your phone, or on your family planner at home, get it in now. What are you waiting for? And then tell your friends if you haven't already. Get excited and come along on Sunday, June the 27th. I'm so looking forward to being back in person and to see you guys there. Secondly, a reminder that Angel Cafe, St John's new community hub cafe, is now open on Fridays from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. So if you like a good cup of coffee, something nice to drink and something yummy to eat, or you just fancy getting out for lunch on a Friday afternoon, come down to Angel Cafe from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Friday. Thirdly and finally, all things being well, we're looking to start Bright Sparks, our St John's toddler group, on Monday the 28th of June from 1:30 to 3:30. And on that date, we're looking to do an outdoor event, a teddy bear's cream tea from 1:30 to 3:30. If you'd like to get involved with that, please send me a text or an email. I'm asking people to make scones and we'll take care of the rest of the refreshments. So that's Monday the 28th of June, 1:30 to 3:30 for our teddy bear's cream tea at Bright Sparks. Well, that's the end of our session this morning. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope it's been fun, encouraging and helpful. There's no Kids Church Online from me next Sunday because I'm going to be speaking in church on the importance of passing on faith to the next generation. If you'd like to come along and support me, please feel free. There will be an online session available through Soul Survivor Watford and their kids ministry, Soul Kids. So you can check out something there if you prefer. I'll see you again on the 13th of June for Kids Church Online. Until then, may God bless you and protect you. Take care of yourselves and each other, and I'll see you really soon. Goodbye.
forget.